Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing, man? Antonelli here.
Hey, what's going on, guys? How we doing, man? Antonelli here, answering questions today. I've been asked a lot about autographs and getting autographs from other players when playing against them. And do players do it? Do they ask other players? When do they ask? And so wanted to go into that a little bit today. So in my experience at the major league level, typically when you show up to a series, right? So it's the first game, usually if you're on the road or at home, players will ask the clubhouse guy, the clubhouse attendant, the clubby, you know, if they could go over and get certain autographs. And I think this happens pretty much every series because usually the club would kind of come around. I remember when I first got called up, you know, guys were talking to him and he just said, hey, do you want to get anybody's autograph over there or anything? Do you want to get anything signed? And I was like, no, I'm good, man. And a decent amount of players got stuff signed. And I remember thinking when I said that, like, I was like, I really, really would like some autographs. Like, Manny Ramirez on the Dodgers, Nomar Garciaparra, Greg Maddux at that time. There was a bunch of really, really good players. And obviously, Manny and Nomar were, like, two of my favorite players of all time, probably my two favorite players of all time. But I didn't ask for it. I remember thinking, like, I'm not going to be the new guy that just ask for autographs like I'm, you know, a fan and I just got called up. I'm like, I'm just here, play the game. Like, play the game, man. You'll get your autographs later. Like, I'll get them next year or I'll get them down the road. And I never, ever got another chance to get autographs, obviously, because I never got called back up again. And so during my career, I got zero autographs. I don't remember ever getting anyone to sign anything for me. And I would have really liked to have like a really big collection of them. But I was just kind of nervous. I just felt awkward. And again, I didn't want to feel like I'm like a fanboy who's trying to collect guys' autographs when I'm trying to play against them. But a lot of guys did. There were some other rookies that collected stuff. And then the veteran guys that are used to, you know, they're obviously been around a lot. They feel more comfortable. They would exchange stuff. And so you could send over, like, I saw guys get baseball signed. I saw some guys send over, like, I remember a guy getting a jersey signed. So basically, if you want stuff, you just bring it down to the, you bring it to the park with you and just give it to the club and be like, hey, could you get, you know, whoever over there to sign these shoes, these cleats or this jersey or whatever. And they would take care of it. And then they, you know, when you came back in from BP, usually you'd just be sitting there or after the game. You know, I'd be sitting there in there in your locker for you. So that's kind of how it works, at least while I was up. That's how it worked. Again, I wish I grabbed more autographs, but I was a pansy and didn't do it. And now I have nobody's. And I only ended up playing barely at all in the major leagues and never got really another chance to grab any autographs. So if you want an autograph, just grab it. Don't wait for the next time. There might never be a next time. That's the moral of the story. Anyways, hope this helps answer your question. Let me know if you have any questions in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel, share the video with all your friends, all that good stuff. Check the description box below. We got a deal going on Plate Crate. We got a link to our Patreon page and a bunch of other stuff, so check all that out. And that's all I got, guys. Thanks so much for watching. I appreciate it, and we'll talk to you later.